One of the species of animals that I'm most excited for on Australia is going to be the crocodile. And in honor of the crocodiles coming soon, today we're going to get some hype going. We're going to be going after some alligators. What do we got out there now? Got a raccoon out there. Pretty sure our first shot must have dropped him because he hasn't moved ever since. Ooh, that's what we're looking for. That's what we're looking for, guys. We're gonna pick up this raccoon and go along the way. Ended up getting a lung, liver, stomach shot, 8.7 at 200 yards. So we actually made an incredible shot as it turned away. Pretty much made a Texas heart shot there, to be honest. Nice. See, I'm thinking it's probably gonna be a lot more of something similar to this, but hopefully it's more open, where there'll be nice spots where you can see from a long ways, and then some spots will be thick like this. Like, see right here, for example, you got a nice little trail, and then you got swamps. And then there's openings where you can see over the top of the ridge in case there's a big gator. But in this case, it's gonna be a croc. All right, we just jumped something up. Oh my God, a freaking gator, holy. I mean, I can't even see it, but we can't get it if we don't take the shot. You know what I mean? We got two shots left. It's going into the water, but it's not very deep here, so we might get a follow-up shot. There it goes! What a horrible shot! I feel like in that case there, we really could have used the red dot. That would have came in so handy. Because it was just a little bit too close to have the scope, so we had to take the scope off. But we needed something aside from that. Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! We got hunting pressure. We got hunting pressure. You know what that means? That's exactly what that means. We got him. Yeah, I was actually kind of joking about this, but I think it'd be really cool if we could get some kind of reel-in retrieval system for alligators that sink down to the bottom, where you could just cast out a line and potentially hook them in order to bring them back in, because that's what you do in real life. First shot was 29 yards. That was the quartering away running shot, and that actually was a solid hit. It was going right for intestine and liver as well. But we didn't get the penetration as to be expected because it was a gator. Wanted to call it a croc, but this is not a croc. And then two shots to the skull. Interesting. And I'm pretty sure he's in the water at this point. But for the most part, oh, there's one. There's one. Ooh, that actually may be a vital shot potential. About 260 yards out. Let's see if we can't get spine and lung. Nope, not getting it. But I don't know if we're gonna be able to get to this one or not. It's pretty deep here. I'm not saying we can't, but I'm not saying we can either. All right, we got hunting pressure. So you're saying there's a chance. And at this point, this is where the hook would come in really handy. What we call them is a drag hook. It's simply just a rope with a big treble hook on the end of it, and it has a sinker attached to it. So you just shuck that sucker out there as far as you possibly can in the direction that you shot, and you pull it in, and you hope that you don't hook into a tree, because if that's the case, you're not gonna be moving it. But if it's a gator, you'll hook it and pull it right in. Now, we've actually attempted this shot one time before and we're able to connect on it. You can get a heart shot if you go right through the middle of the mouth, but you got to go a little bit low and a little bit right to compensate for that. Otherwise, you'll hit the jaw and you don't want to do that, but we'll try for it. 270 yards and let's see if we can make this happen. Did not, I repeat, did not make it happen. But we attempted it. One of them did. Non-vital hit. And that looks like a vital hit. Or maybe One is a no organs hit, and one is a non-vital hit. Nonetheless, one of those shots definitely took down this gator. So, first shot was jaw. Oh my god, did we barely miss the heart, you guys. Look at that. The heart was right in line with that. But we just nicked the jaw. If we went to hit the jaw and we would have hit right there, we could have got a heart shot. Ooh, here we go. A nice level 7 right there, 150 yards out. Now, I do believe we could go for a nice vital hit and it would take it down. Oh, son of a... Got a decent 170 buck out there, and it's actually going to be a lot of fun to be able to hunt for the crocs while we find roosted deer along the way. Made a nice shot, and I do believe he just tipped over. Surprisingly, that wasn't actually a double lung shot. There's our shot, 271 yard left lung shot. That's why we only got a single lung, because it was quartering away just a little bit, but perfect shot right there in a 166. I do believe there actually was a big 7 or potentially a mythical over here at one point. Pretty sure it was a big 7. Yeah, it should be a 7. According to that track, should be a 7. Oh my god, it's a mythical! What are the odds of that? Like, I can't even see. Oh, there it is. Now I see it. Can't miss that. So there's the female. And there is the giant mythical, max weight and max scoring estimate as well. And this shot needs to be absolutely precise. So we're talking about 250 yards. Need to put this right on the money. Boy, that looked good. And if it wasn't, that should have been even better. Unfortunately, we can't shoot it anymore. We are not getting any hunting pressure from that. And I am honestly completely... Oh my god! I was just going to say, I'm completely blown away that that thing is not going down after all those shots. And all of a sudden, he just pops right up. Holy, that was a long time for him to float up. And I mean a long time. Right there is the female, as a matter of fact. She is right behind those trees. So we're going to go for a shot on her as we're waiting for this mythical to float in. So why is she going down so fast? That's odd. I feel like we took pretty much the exact same shot on this one. Son of a... Oh my god, we missed the neck by a half an inch. Unbelievable. Would have been a phenomenal shot if it was a half inch more to the left. So that would have been fine if had our second shot connected. But because it was so far out and it was running, we got him a little too far back. I shot for right here and we hit way back here. Oh, that's a tough one. That is a tough one. Especially the fact that he scored 448, which is a massive, massive mythical. Holy, we got a couple of gators right out there, and that looks like... How many gators are over there? I think we hit the absolute jackpot on gators. We got a huge 7, we got a 6, and a female. But we definitely want to make a nice shot on this 7 to make up for messing up that last one. Boy, I can't really see it. It's right in that shadow. Absolutely the worst spot it could possibly be. All right, so there it is right there. You can kind of see it. What I'm trying to do is figure out if we can get a shot off here. Probably like that. Boy, that should have been close to heart. Oh my god, it was! Holy. Beautiful shot. Wow. Well, we didn't mess that one up, I'll tell you that. This is a massive level 7 as well. Oh, I have a track from a max weight gator right here. And it's not the same one. Because he's not highlighted blue. So that's a good sign. That means there's two massive gators in this area. But it's going to be a 422 gold. And we pulled off a 157 yard lower neck and left lung. So perfect shot. We got neck and lung on that. Now, I think the crocodiles have a more of a square head, if I remember right. The alligators have kind of a pointy head. Well, we got a call from another Maxway alligator. We just found the track and he called right over there. So there's a good chance it's going to be a nice one. The wind is blowing kind of directly towards him, so we got to be careful. There it is, there it is, there it is. Go, 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 go. Couldn't really get a good look at it, but it's cut across right in front of... Oh my god, there's two of them. That was a 5 medium. Dude, this is freaking awesome. Oh, what's that one? That one's already down. What's this one? What's this one? So, female. That one's already down as well. Oh my god, we just friggin' smoked the gators. Holy, are you kidding me? That was unbelievable. We're talking three gators stacked up right here. Three of them. Oh, we got some whitetail over there. But we never did actually see him, so he could be anywhere, and I don't know how big he's going to be either. It's a decent buck out there, actually. Check this out. Smoked him. Couldn't even see him. So here's this gator. Neck shot. It was actually a gold. Two neck shots. Lower neck and then a neck shot. And here's this one. It was a female. Another running neck shot. And this should be another male. Yes, it is. A lung shot, liver, and skull shot. A very nice shooting there. 62 yards out on the run. But now we got to try and figure out where that max weight gator is. Well, here's a buck that we dropped at 315 yards. We couldn't even hardly see him because he was in the brush, but we pulled off a double lung shot, and the shot was actually 340 yards, a 184 whitetail buck. I had a dog, and his name was Bingo. We found our giant mythical right there. I was hoping he might be a little bit bigger, but he's still massive. 388 to 464, and that is where the track led us to. Hold up, there's another one there. Is right there. Well, the mythical is 320. Okay, yeah, so we'll go 300. That's a hit. It was a 7, a big 7. This is one of the most difficult shots we've taken all day, and we ended up pulling off a shoulder blade lung shot at 316 yards, and that shot was so money. It was absolutely perfect. I mean, all we could do is really silhouette him, but it worked out amazing. 414 gold. There it goes, right there! Of course, I grabbed the friggin' 338. I don't know how I'm gonna be able to get this thing down. Man, it happened so fast. I was trying to record, trying to get the right rifle out, trying to turn the tracks off. I literally did one of the three things. I got the right rifle out, and we made the shot, but... Shot too many times. 418. He was a massive one too. So I knew that first shot was going to be stomach, but the follow-up shot, I tried to get lung, and we actually somehow managed to get it. Then I shot one more time just to slow it up a little bit more, because I didn't think it would be shallow enough here to get him, and apparently it was. Well, that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know, are you excited about hunting for the crocodile, or what's your favorite species that you're most looking forward to hunting when Australia drops? Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.